দর্শক, আমরা কথা বলছিলাম সোফিয়ানের সাথে, ব্রিটিশ বিজ্ঞানী যিনি বাংলাদেশের হুইট ব্লাস্ট নিয়ে, অর্থাৎ গমের ব্লাস্ট রোগ নিয়ে কাজ করছেন এবং উনি চেষ্টা করছেন কিভাবে ক্রিসপার কাস টেকনোলজি ব্যবহার করে বাংলাদেশের ব্লাস্ট রেজিস্ট্যান্ট ভ্যারাইটি ডেভেলপ করা যায়, বিশেষ করে গমের ক্ষেত্রে। উনি বলছেন যে শুধু গম না, চাইলে আমরা অন্যান্য ফসলের ক্ষেত্রেও আমরা ক্রিসপার কাস টেকনোলজি ব্যবহার করতে পারি। উই নো ইউ হ্যাভ এ ওয়েল এস্টাবলিশড ল্যাব ইন ইউকে, so how Bangladeshi biotechnologists can involve in your lab?
Many ways. I mean, we have been now working with Professor Tofazzal Islam for 3 years after the terrible outbreak of wheat blast in 2016. We have a very vibrant collaboration with him and his team, and we're expecting to have more of those interactions. We hope to have more of the workshops like the one we had this week, and also interactions through contacts and exchanges of visits and hosting scientists and so on. So we hope to do more of that. We are quite optimistic that we will do more in the future. Bangladesh is very important to us because this country, agriculture is extremely important. We appreciate your work as an agricultural science journalist. So we know how important it is, and there will be, from what I read, there will be 40 million more people in Bangladesh in the next 30 years. To population growth, so we need to feed them, right? And we need to feed them a healthy, safe and nutritious diet. So we all need to ensure that food is there, but also that food is high quality. So this is important. This is my field. This is my work. So Bangladesh is a fantastic country to interact with and apply new methods and help transfer technology and help also learn from you in terms of what the problems are and how we can deal with them.
So you are talking about food security. Sure. So CRISPR-Cas technology could be the main tool of food security or safe food?
Absolutely. I truly believe CRISPR-Cas9 is going to be routinely applied in agriculture in the coming years. I don't like to give a timeline and tell you specifically which years, because there are many factors that I do not control. But I am certain that in this century, CRISPR-Cas9 is going to revolutionize agriculture, and in particular crop breeding. It's an amazing technology. You know, if you imagine if the genome, you know, the genome of the plant, imagine if it's a text and you have a word processor that allows you to change just one letter. This is the ultimate. We cannot do better than that.
Anyway, what is your message to our young scientists or young biotechnologists about science and definitely CRISPR-Cas technology?
I really appreciate that you asked me this question, because I care a lot about young scientists. They are the future, you know, we are getting old, and I believe those young scientists, I could see from their eyes and their attention, their focus, that they are so excited. And they will grow up with these technologies. They are learning them already at the university, you know. 5 years ago, I was only dreaming about this, and they are learning it at the university. This is amazing, right? So I truly believe the potential, especially in this country where young people are so important and are really, I think, a huge message of hope associated with the younger generation. I think they will have a huge impact, and I'm really excited to be part of that and help facilitate this.
Well, so far we know you are promoting open science and open data sharing. So what is open science and why you do this?
That's a great question. So the traditional way of doing science is kind of strange, really, if you think about it, because scientists do the research in their lab, they discover things, but they don't immediately share them with their colleagues. They usually will keep working on that for several years, and then publish them in a scientific journal, and at that time, the information is shared with all the community and all the other scientists, and the public, of course. Frankly, I think this approach is a bit outdated in this time and age where we have digital media and where we can immediately exchange information wherever you are in the world and so on. So this is what open science is about. Open science is about immediately sharing the information and not waiting until it's formally published in a scientific journal before you actually share it. And this is particularly important when we have emerging diseases, emergencies, like the wheat blast problem in 2016. That was an emergency. Imagine if you wait 1 year before actually revealing what the identity of the organism is and before informing the colleagues and the media and maybe even neighboring countries about what the problem is. This is unacceptable in case of emergency. This is why I've been very strongly advocating for open science and advocating for data sharing, and also we are currently promoting a code of ethics for people in my field, plant pathology, for how to deal with new problems, emergencies, and so on. This is very important.
What are the challenges?
Oh, many challenges, because first of all, this is not in the culture of scientists. Culturally, scientists first want to publish their data in scientific journals. This is important, you know, for how they get promoted, how they get new jobs, and so on. So the main challenge really is cultural change among scientists. Really, reassuring them that if you're going to share your data, you will actually benefit from that. There will be incentives to get them recognized for the data they are sharing. And also, these days, this does not prevent you from formally publishing the science after a few months or even after a few years. You can still share your data and still publish it. So there are challenges, but really, this is for the scientific community to sort out. And I hope that the public and the governments and the funding agencies really put pressure on scientists to push them towards more towards open science.
Thank you, Sufyan. We are talking about a lot of things regarding wheat blast, also genome and technology. দর্শক আমরা কথা বলছিলাম বাংলাদেশের ব্লাস্ট রোগ নিয়ে, বিশেষ করে গমের যে ব্লাস্ট রোগ আছে সেটি নিয়ে আমাদের কথা হচ্ছিল। জিনোম এডিটিং টেকনোলজি ব্যবহার করে গমের ব্লাস্ট প্রকৃতি জাত আবিষ্কার করবেন এবং সেই জাত নিশ্চয়ই গমের ব্লাস্ট রোগ নির্মূল করবে। দেখা হবে নতুন কোনো পর্বে। আজকে এ পর্যন্তই, ভালো থাকবেন সবাই।